This tutorial shows you how to calculate the minimum required sample size for the one-way ANOVA with SPSS itself. To minimize the beta error as a result of insufficient power, an a priori sample size calculation is done. Or put another way, you want to minimize the chances of not being able to observe existing effects. In SPSS, go through Analyze, Power Analysis, Means, One-Way ANOVA. First, make sure that it says Estimate Sample Size, since that is what you want to calculate. Second, you can either enter a single power value or grid power values. If you have specific guidelines regarding power, you will choose single power value. For context, power equals 1 minus the beta error probability. Beta error is the type 2 error. In short, this means falsely retaining the null hypothesis. If you want to calculate sample sizes based on multiple power values or even a range, let's say from 0.8 to 0.95 in 0.05 steps, you can define that here as well. I will use single power value of 0.95 and therefore have a 5% type 2 error probability. In some research fields, 0.8 is used here. This means you automatically accept a type 2 error of up to 20%. If you have power lower than 0.95, this usually calls for a reasonable justification. Thirdly, you have to specify either A, a hypothesized value, or B, one of two effect sizes. If you have information about the pooled population standard deviation, you can use it here. However, the pooled population standard deviation is most likely unknown, and you will use known effect sizes from comparable studies. Those effect sizes can either be Cohen's F or Eta squared, depending on what comparable studies report. You can also transform F to Eta squared and the other way around, using the formulas provided in Cohen 1988, page 281 and 284 respectively. The conventions for F for the behavioral sciences are 0.1, 0.25 and 0.4 for small, medium and large effect sizes, taken from Cohen 92, a power primer. If you have research field specific thresholds though, or effect sizes from preliminary or comparable studies, use those instead. Fourthly, you can define the number of groups by repeatedly pressing add. If you have information about the ratios of groups to total sample size, you can weigh the groups accordingly. By the way, group sizes cannot be entered in any a priori sample size calculations and you must use group weights only. A little bonus tip, try and have roughly equal group sizes when recruiting subjects or making observations. This will solve some headaches, especially when it comes to homogeneity of variances. This assumption for the ANOVA goes out the window if you have equal group sizes. You can, however, still correct for that, see my video on that. If you choose hypothesized values, you can further enter group means. The final input parameter needed is the significance level, aka the alpha error probability, which is the probability of committing a type 1 error. In short, this is the probability of wrongly rejecting the null hypothesis. 5% is the typical convention. 1% is a bit more restrictive. A value above 5% should be avoided. Finally, hit OK to see the minimum number of observations needed to detect the presumed statistical effect with the predefined type 1 error probability and power. As a rule of thumb, a smaller effect size and a larger power require more observations than the other way around.